Previously on Speak to the Geek.
The hot water tank needs to go here.
Installation day has arrived.
This massive box here has got to be the heat pump itself, I assume.
So here's one of the radiators they've installed. Bit of chaos here in the house right now. Yeah, that boiler's definitely not going to work anymore. There's just a great big cap on the end of where it comes in. So they've built the base for the heat pump to go on. Daikin controller's on the wall now. So there it is in position. I don't think we're going to get hot showers tomorrow.
It's cold and I'm hungry.
Should be insulating it a lot better. I think I need to get one of those thermal cameras. No hot water, no heating. Day four then. Well, I don't like being without hot water, I'll tell you that now. It's not fun. I don't like missing my morning shower. I really do like a shower in the morning, and being without hot water, it just doesn't feel right. So I had a bit of a Glastonbury shower with the old wet wipes this morning, but it's not the same. Speaking of showers, I've just been up in the loft swapping over the pipes and things for my shower that's in the ensuite. It's a digital shower, and they changed the pump over for just a controller for me yesterday, but I've gone and changed the actual bit with buttons on. I'll put an overlay so as you can see what I'm on about, and the handheld part of the shower. I'm going to get them to check over my plumbing before they actually turn it on, because I don't trust my plumbing skills at all. What else? Today they are running the pipes from the heat pump into the garage, so they've been working on that this morning, and hopefully I'll be able to have an actual proper shower this evening. While I've got you, don't forget to subscribe to find out what else happens in this little series of videos, because there are going to be many more videos where I'm going to bore you to pieces talking about the heat pump that's going in. And if you're not a customer of Octopus Energy already, then please do consider signing up with them. They are a very good energy supplier, and if you sign up using my code that's on the screen right now, then we both get £50. And yes, it helps to support the channel, so thank you. Anyway, on with the install. Don't know what I'm going to talk to you about next, but I'm sure it'll be really interesting. So it's 20 to 6 now, and I've been staying out of their way for most of the day, to be honest, because I think they're a little bit behind. They got stuck in a massive Welsh rainy downpour, which didn't help, so they've had to get a gazebo in the back garden so as they can work. They have now got pipes running from the heat pump to the plant area, so I think they're planning to start filling the system full of water. But yeah, they say they're going to have a late one tonight until about 7 o'clock, so hopefully we might have it up and running, but we'll find out soon. So they've just left for the day. It's 7:30 in the evening. We don't have heating yet, but we might have hot water using the immersion heater. The reason we don't have the heating working yet is they just didn't want to fill the radiators this late in the evening, just in case there are leaks and things they need to fix. But they're going to do it first thing tomorrow morning and then start commissioning the system. So let's have a look at what they've done. You can see these pipes down here are running from the heat pump all the way up the wall, around under the overhang and into the garage. So I've got a lot of work putting a box out on that once they've finished, and they're going to have to put some insulation on it too. So let's look at what they've got inside today. You can see the MMI is there, which says it's got the booster heater on, and the tank temperature is 11 degrees. That's going to take a long time to heat using the 3 kilowatt immersion heater. We've got a filter there, and I think that's a motorized valve. There must be a pump somewhere, but I can't see it. Oh, and over here, the boiler has gone. Just a big hole in the wall, so I'm hoping that there'll be some sort of cover or something to sort that out, because I don't particularly want a rat hole on the wall. I just thought, maybe there is no pump on the actual water circuit. Maybe it's actually built into the heat pump itself, that's why I can't find one here. I don't know, I'll ask them tomorrow. And the internal thermostat's also live. I'm not going to play with that, even though it says 15.5 degrees and it's quite cold in the rest of the house. I'll let them play with that tomorrow once they start commissioning it. I've already installed the app on my phone, so hopefully that bit will be straightforward. Day five, and still no hot water or heating, but the heat pump is powered on and working. It's doing something. It's drawing a couple of kilowatts, so I'll put an overlay so you can see what's going on there. But yeah, I don't yet have hot water or heating. I think that's because they haven't filled the radiators with water yet. They're currently outside lagging the pipes, so that's good news for insulation purposes, and I think they're getting ready to fill the system any minute. There's a bit of drilling and banging going on in the garage. It was another night, therefore, without heating and hot water, so I didn't get hot water as I'd hoped. That was probably because the immersion heater only came on for about half an hour by the looks of it, and also one of the valves that feeds the bottom of the hot water tank was turned off. I didn't want to turn it on just in case it caused a problem. But anyway, this is the last day of this install. So even if it's not the last day of this install, it's going to be the last day of this video. So hopefully by the end of this video, you will see it all working. This radiator's warm. And this radiator's warm. So's this radiator. This one here is really warm. And the bedroom radiator's warm at last. Heating in the bedroom is going to make for a much better night's sleep. I'm not going to go around all the radiators. They're all pretty much getting warm. Yay. And I need to show you this, right? Here we go. A working shower. And it's warm. Here it is then. Fully operating and heating the house. And there's my cat going in after staying away from all the installers for a few days. Yeah, it's blowing out freezing cold air as you'd expect, but the house is actually getting too warm for me right now. I've been used to it being cold. But yeah, I'm quite pleased with how it's gone so far. Everything's working, everything's been done by the book. I think even Heat Geek would be pleased. All the pipes are fully lagged, lots of insulation going around them. Clearly I've got to go and sort out this box out, but I mentioned that earlier, that's not a problem at all. And the inside is all finished too, they've insulated all of the pipes. It looks a really neat job. And here's the controller. I have got to keep an eye on the pressure apparently, got to keep it above one. Sadly there's no way to remotely monitor that, so I have to keep coming in here and checking this screen every now and then. So it's been connected up to the official Daikin app, and also they've configured it to work through the Octopus app as well. You can't do schedules in the Octopus app, it's just for controlling the temperature set points, but all the schedules are set up in the Daikin Onecta. I don't know what you call it, but the official Daikin app anyway, and it's all Wi-Fi connected from that little MMI box there. The Wi-Fi signal in here is a bit weak, so I've got to fix that at some point. But that's really the only issue so far, and that's all my fault. Yeah, that's it for this video. Don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to my channel, because I'm going to be talking a lot more about this heat pump over the next few months. Lots of data, lots of things like that, Home Assistant integration, that sort of stuff. Please don't forget, like and subscribe, as you have to say in these videos. Thank you for watching. Bye.